Dine into Echo's Road open. Norton wins PNC election. Minibus tout remanded for murder. And lock safety laws are killing Guyanese workers. I'm the Recorporal Ford, and this is Uncut News. If you see news happening, send us a tip on WhatsApp at 592-659-6151. This morning, the Makoto Great Diamond Road was officially opened for traffic. The president warned motorists against speeding and announced that traffic laws would be amended to provide for electronic ticketing. Additionally, the road is only open to passenger vehicles, trucks, and SUVs. Heavy-duty trucks will still be restricted to the East Bank Public Road. Officials said the cost of this road is 5 billion Guyana dollars. Housing Minister Colin Crowell said the new road opens up about 300 to 400 acres of land for commercial and industrial development, as well as additional house lots. He said about 18,000 persons live along the new road. Meanwhile, the Ekwasi Diamond Link would be cleared and work would begin next year. The president said the Mandela to Diamond Road link would cost 16 billion Guyana dollars in addition to the proposed Ogle to Eccles connection. Yes, it's many different connections going on here. On Sunday, Aubrey Norton won the PNCR's internal elections. Norton beat out Harmon and Van West Charles for the position of the leader of the PNCR. However, Norton is not the leader of the coalition or the parliamentary opposition just yet. As Harmon said, he does not intend to step down from the position. Complicating the matter further is that Granger, as the leader of the last list submitted to GCOM, controls who is given a seat in parliament, even though he was not nominated in this internal party election for any leadership post. Nevertheless, Norton's candidate for chairman, Shoane Holder, was also successful. For the first time in our nation's history, the Ministry of Education will be giving all pupils in grades 1 to 6 in the public school system all of the textbooks needed for their studies. They are currently standardizing the list of textbooks used at the secondary school level so that a similar initiative can be implemented there. 22 containers with textbooks are currently en route to Guyana. They plan to distribute the books as soon as they arrive. 74-year-old Savitri Umrao is now traumatized after she and a guest was on Sunday evening attacked and robbed by two knife-wielding bandits who invaded her home at Blairmont, West Coast Babies. After beating and terrorizing the two, Umrao was robbed of several pieces of gold jewelry, including her earrings, which they ripped off her ears. They then ran off with the ill-gotten goods and have yet to be caught. Now it's time to tell you about Best Buy's car of the day. Currently on sale is this 2011 Subaru Forester XT. It comes with all-wheel drive, driving modes, Bluetooth, mark rims, new tires, TV, CD, stereo, reverse camera, rear spoiler, and much more. Buy cash for $4.7 million. Our pay down as low as $940,000 down with around $106,500 monthly for 4 years, and it is yours. Call or WhatsApp 662-0844 for more info. Or visit the showrooms at Lot 171 Peter Street, Queenstown, or Lot 2 Lama Street, and tell them the request entry for this sweet deal. Today, 27-year-old minibus tout Paul Junior Lynch was remanded to prison for fatally stabbing 30-year-old Morvin Nurse in front of the Starbucks Market on December 15th. He was not required to enter a plea to the charge, and was remanded to prison until February 21st, 2022. The Ministry of Labour has gotten the management of Troy Resources Guyana Inc. to promise to pay dismissed workers the legally required severance pay they were supposed to receive after being sent home. All terminated workers should be given their severance / redundancy allowances and all other benefits owed to them by the first quarter of 2022, supposedly. On Monday, 44-year-old engineer Mervyn George and 25-year-old driver Daniel Baker were charged for defrauding the government of over $1.1 million. They were accused of inflating the number of truckloads of laterite they delivered for the rehabilitation of a stretch of road at 6 miles Bartica. According to the courts, they claimed to have delivered 233 truckloads, but a physical observation revealed only 87 truckloads were delivered at a cost of $18,000 per truckload. They were released on $150,000 bail. You can move into your very own luxury home in 2022. Lenora Estates West Coast and Morara Properties could have you saying goodbye to your landlord in no time. Call or WhatsApp 592-618-5702 and ask about in-house finance. This morning, another young man died in a tragic workplace accident. 18-year-old laborer Tularam Harilol was crushed to death by a reversing lorry in the compound of Huck Rice Mill in Golden Grove, West Coast Burbies. Another employee was operating the truck and did not see Harry Lowell until he was alerted by another worker nearby. But by then, it was already too late to save Harry Lord. It's now time for today's Rona Report. Today, the nation recorded 21 new cases. There are now 1,033 persons dead. There are 11 persons in the ICU, 713 in home isolation, and the total number of confirmed cases around the nation now stands at 38,891. So please, people, wash your hands frequently. Avoid touching your nose and mouth and mask up before you leave the house. When you do leave home, try to avoid enclosed spaces and large crowds. And remember to give 6 feet of space between you and others. And now for the vaccine update. To date, 408,838 or 79.7% of adults have had their first dose, and 291,688 or 56.7% are fully vaccinated. As for the teenagers, 30,028 or 41.2% have had their first dose of the vaccine, and 21,309 or 29.2% are fully vaccinated. Are you still using a Mongo Pelter by choice, or you simply can't afford a new cell phone? Good news for you! Digicel is slashing prices in half on the Samsung A3, the DL3 Pro, and Pro Plus this Christmas. Upgrade to a brand new smartphone for just $9,750 at any Cellular Plus Digicel store. This offer includes a free 1 month Prime Bundle data plan. Pro tip, smartphones make good presents. It's now time for our stupid news of the day. You know what I think is stupid? Just how little businesses in this nation care about the lives of their employees. Well, for one, they think it's acceptable to pay someone less than $300 a month. I think that's enough to show how little they care. Second, they do not care the least bit about worker safety. Minibus touts and big businessmen in Guyana have one thing in common. They both have a severe disregard for the safety of others that it honestly borders on the homicidal. It almost seems like every other week we hear of another young person dying while they are trying to make an honest living. And despite the constant deaths, you never hear of any employer getting charged or fined. The Ministry of Labor always claims to do an investigation, but 9 out of 10 times there's no follow-up. This has made an environment where employers feel no need to spend the money on safety equipment or even safety training for their employees because it's just cheaper to replace them once they decide to find a better job or they just die of some terrible accident. So, if local employers are able to view their employees as disposable, then it shouldn't be surprising when multi-billion-dollar foreign corporations treat all Guyanese with such little regard. All this is to say that the government needs to take a serious stance on workplace health and safety, compel businesses to give their employees proper training to reduce workplace injuries and deaths, also give them the proper equipment they need to do their jobs safely. Because when it comes to safety, we can no longer use the excuse of, this is Guyana. Because at this rate, by 2035, the only ones who are going to be left behind in Guyana are the Guyanese. And that is pretty stupid. Moving on to our Uncut News Poll Question of the Day. Every day we pose a question about current events in Guyana, the region, the diaspora, and how you feel it relates to us. So, you give your responses in the comments, and we'll read the best ones in the following episode. Friday's question was, since the government is so eager to throw around billions, I want to know what worthwhile venture do you believe this nation should be investing in? Barefoot Wanderer says, spend money to educate. Raise the literacy level of all Guyanese of all races. Educate all adults and children about domestic violence, alcohol, and drug abuse. Have programs to help rehabilitate the victims and abusers, and the generational curse. Promote the elevation of one's existence. Respect oneself and each other. Teach Guyanese real history and the diaspora to students, not the history that's written by past colonizers. We all know Columbus discovered nothing. Exactly, he discovered nothing. Develop a proper museum, displaying the Middle Passage ships, logs of ships, slaves, and indentured laborers. Display and promote Guyanese art, literature, books, poems written by Guyanese authors and Caribbean artists. Invest in skilled trade, schools to uplift the youth. We need to teach self-pride of who we are. Without knowing our history, we cannot move forward with a definitive purpose. Educate and elevate the Guyanese people. Well, he basically said it all right there. What? Anyway, Tarifa Wolford said to invest in small businesses and also get these big mining companies under control. And finally, RC View Farm says invest in modern automated sluices and an electronic trolley system to get rid of the minibuses. Oh yeah, I agree with you on getting rid of those minibuses. So, before we get to tonight's question, you there, Mr. Truckman, get all your high-quality truck parts at 5 to 15% off during the Christmas season. Nice up your truck and get it ready for work in 2022. Visit Powered Automotive Truck Spares and Engine Parts at 1161 EE Eccles. They are the biggest truck parts store in Ghana, with a wide variety of parts and exceptional customer service. Call or WhatsApp 697-0171. For tonight's question, Aubrey Norton has won the PNC internal election. Do you believe that he can actually change things for the party? Why or why not? Think about that question to us in the comments below. If your response is good enough, we just might feature it in the next episode. Anyway, that's all the time we have for tonight, and check us out tomorrow for another. Until then, I'm Rico Bullford saying good night, folks.
Hey, Uncut News viewers, thanks for watching. You can subscribe by clicking on this button over here, or click over there for more news. You can also drop a comment to let me know if you've made it to the end of the video. Goodbye for now!